Topological manifolds, which are our main object of interest at the moment, give us an opportunity to put in use the Urysohn metrization theorem, which we proved in the last chapter. So recall that this theorem says that if we have a space X, which is regular and second countable, then such space is metrizable. So it means that we can equip it with a metric which is compatible with its topology. My goal in this video will be to use this result to prove the theorem which says that every topological manifold is a metrizable space. For the proof of this theorem, we'll need a lemma which says the following. Let's say that we have some n-dimensional manifold. Let's call this manifold M. And let's say that we have some coordinate chart defined on this manifold. So it means that we have some open subset, call it U, of this manifold, and we have a homeomorphism, call it phi, going to some open subset, which we'll denote by V, of the n-dimensional Euclidean space Rn. And now let's assume that in Rn we have a closed ball which is entirely contained inside of this set V. So closed ball means ball together with its boundary. So this is closed ball with center at some point x and some radius r, but a ball which is entirely contained inside of this set V, the codomain of our coordinate chart. Then we can take the inverse image of this closed ball, and that will be some subset of this set U. So this is the inverse image of this closed ball. And now this lemma says that this inverse image will be a closed set of the manifold M. Now, a coordinate chart is a homeomorphism, so in particular it is a continuous function. And as we know, one of the properties of continuous functions is that if we take a closed set, and a closed ball in Rn is a closed subset of Rn, and if we take the inverse image of this closed set under a continuous function, then this set will be again a closed set. However, this will be a closed subset of the domain of the function, which in our case is the set U. A set which is a closed subset of U doesn't have to be in general a closed subset of the whole manifold M. So what is special about this lemma is that it is telling us that if we take a closed ball in Rn, and if we take the inverse image of this closed ball taken with respect to this coordinate chart, then we are getting a set which is not just closed subset of U, of the domain of this coordinate chart, but it is a closed subset of the whole manifold. And that's something which does not follow just from the continuity of this coordinate chart. The proof of this lemma goes slightly beyond of what we can do at the moment because it uses the notion of compactness of topological spaces, and we haven't gotten there yet. So I will leave this statement without proof for the moment, but very soon we will be in position to prove it. So, assuming for now that this lemma is true, let's get to the proof of this theorem, which says that every manifold is a metrizable space. So, here is the proof of this theorem. So, let's assume that M is a manifold. For simplicity, I'll be assuming here that this is a manifold without boundary. But essentially the same argument that we'll be using here will work for all manifolds, regardless if they have boundary or not. Now, the Urysohn metrization theorem, which we have at the top of this page, is telling us that in order to verify that a manifold is metrizable space, it's enough to check that this manifold is a space which is regular and it is second countable. By definition, every manifold is a space which is second countable. So the only thing that we need to check is that every manifold is a regular space. So it suffices to check that M is regular. Now, recall that regularity of M means that if we have this manifold, in this manifold we have some closed set, let's call this closed set A, and we have some point X which is outside of this closed set, then in such situation we should be always able to find an open neighborhood of this closed set, let's call this neighborhood V, and we should be able to find an open neighborhood of this point X, let's call it W, such that these open neighborhoods do not intersect. So let's assume that we have this manifold M, we have this closed set A, and we have this point X, and now let's try to construct those neighborhoods. First of all, since M is a manifold, we can find some open neighborhood of this point X and a coordinate chart which is defined on this open neighborhood. Now, as I was telling you before, without loss of generality, we can assume that this coordinate chart is mapping this open neighborhood to the whole space Rn, and moreover, we can assume that this point X is being mapped by this coordinate chart to the origin of Rn. So altogether, this coordinate chart is giving us a homeomorphism between this open neighborhood of X and Rn, and a homeomorphism which is sending this point X to point zero, to the origin of Rn. Since by our assumption the set A is closed in the whole manifold M, then by subspace topology, if we take the intersection of A with set U, then this will give us a set which is closed in the set U. However, phi is a homeomorphism, and homeomorphism is taking closed sets to closed sets, so this is telling us that phi of A intersected with U will be again a closed set, but now a closed set in the codomain of our homeomorphism, so a closed set in Rn. Moreover, since by assumption the point X does not belong to the set A, then that will give us that the image of this point, so the point phi of X, does not belong to the set phi of A intersected with U. So, as a result, we are obtaining a closed set in Rn, the set phi of A intersected with U, and we are obtaining this point phi of X, which is a point somewhere outside of this closed set. Since Rn is a regular space, because it is a metric space, we can find an open ball of some possibly very small radius epsilon and center at this point phi of X, such that this open ball does not intersect with this closed set phi of A intersected with U. So here is this ball with center at phi of X and some radius epsilon, ball so small that the intersection of this ball with this closed set phi of A intersected with U is an empty set. Now, let's take even smaller ball, a ball with the same center at the point phi of X, but with radius epsilon over 2. So a ball which looks more or less like this. So this is ball with center at phi of X and radius epsilon divided by 2. I am claiming that in this situation we can define those open neighborhoods that we want, so the neighborhood W of the point X and the open neighborhood V of this closed set A as follows, that we will set that W is simply the inverse image of this smaller ball taken with respect to this function phi, and as V we will take the complement in the manifold of the inverse image under the very same function of the closure of this ball with radius epsilon divided by 2. So now let's verify that these two sets, V and W, are satisfying all the conditions that we want them to satisfy. So first of all, W is an inverse image of an open ball, inverse image taken with respect to this homeomorphism phi. So this is telling us that this set is an open set in the domain of this function phi, so in the set U. However, by assumption, U by itself is an open set inside of the manifold M. So taking it together, we are obtaining that this W is not just an open subset of U, but it is also an open subset of the whole manifold. Moreover, since phi of x belongs to the ball, it is actually the center of the ball, then that means that the point x will be in the inverse image of the ball, so that will be in the set W. So this is telling us that indeed, set W defined in this way is giving us some open neighborhood of this point x in the manifold M. Next, to see that the set V is also an open subset of M, we need to refer back to this lemma that we have above. The lemma which is telling us that if we have a coordinate chart and if we have a closed ball which is contained inside of the codomain of this coordinate chart, then the inverse image of this closed ball is a closed subset of the manifold. So now in our situation, we have this closed ball and we are taking the inverse image of this closed ball taken with respect to a coordinate chart. So by the lemma, we are obtaining that this inverse image is a closed set in M. So closed in M by lemma. Well, but complements of closed sets are open sets, so it tells us that now if we take this complement, then that will give us a set which is open in the manifold. So we obtain that indeed this set V is an open set in the manifold. Moreover, set V consists of all the points of manifold M except for the points which are being mapped by phi to this closed ball with center at phi of x and radius epsilon divided by 2. However, all the points of set A are being mapped outside of this even bigger ball of radius epsilon. So there are no points of A which are being mapped to this smaller ball with radius epsilon divided by 2. So the upshot is that all the points of A are inside of this complement, so all the points of A are inside of this set V. So this tells us that we are obtaining indeed an open set V which is containing set A. Finally, notice that set W consists of all the points of the manifold which are being mapped by phi to this open ball of radius epsilon divided by 2, and V consists of all the points of the manifold which are not being mapped by phi to the closure of this open ball. So this is telling us that those sets V and W are disjoint sets, just as we wanted them to be. So altogether, we obtained an open neighborhood W of this point X and open neighborhood V of this closed set A, such that these two neighborhoods are disjoint. And since we can perform this construction for arbitrary closed set and arbitrary point outside of this closed set, then that tells us that this manifold M is indeed a regular space. So, going back to the Urysohn metrization theorem, we have proved that every manifold is a regular space. By definition, every manifold is second countable. So, Urysohn metrization theorem is telling us that every manifold is a metrizable space, and this is precisely what we are trying to prove.